What's good, everyone? What is good? Welcome back to the channel with yours truly, of course, Machiavelli. And today we're back with another episode of The Sims 4. I'm getting this all wrong. With a new LP, which is for The Sims 4 Get Famous. Let's go. Yeah, guys, what's up? So, a new LP. Super, super excited for this one. I'm super excited for this one. I can't wait to get into it. So we're doing Get Famous, of course, because this is the new expansion pack. But before I start anything, let me just introduce myself for any new viewers. Hello, everyone. My name is Malik, but I go by Mac on YouTube. Right now, I kind of have low energy because it is 2 o'clock in the morning. I just got everything set for this LP, so if I have low energy, let me be. I'm definitely excited, just a bit tired. I make Sims 4 LPs and speed builds. When I do my LPs, I play with storylines, and that if that's not for you, then I recommend you don't watch this then. But if it is for you, then stay tuned. So that's pretty much about moi. So let's get straight into the Sims 4 LP. So as you can see, we have two Sims hugging right here. So we have two Sims. So first we have over here, we have the one and only Gabriella Moore, and then over here we have her brother. I mix up his name about 5 different times, so I don't remember which one I actually end up going with. Is it Aiden, or did I change it? His name was supposed to be Aiden, but then I changed it, so I don't know if I changed it or not. It could have still be Aiden. We're gonna call Aiden for now, and this is Aiden Moore. They are siblings. They're not twins. She's older by a year, and yeah, so they're not twins. I guess I actually should I do a backstory first? Okay, I'll introduce them first and who they are and their relationships. I'll talk about that after, but I'll introduce who they are first, and then I will get into them. So first we have, we'll talk about, I guess he's the older one. I could be wrong. I don't know. I guess they made him the older one. Oh, well. Wait. He's at 0, right? Okay, they're both at 0. Because, anyways, when I started this game, they all had, like, they're all at, like, about to become adults. I was like, what? But anyways, I fixed it. So, we have Aiden Moore. Aiden is a family-oriented. He's romantic. He is a geek, and he is alluring because his trait is soulmate. I did it for now. I'm definitely gonna change that in the future, but just for now, at least that's what his aspiration is gonna be. He does not have a job yet. I'm kind of still working out what I want to do with him. I know that he is definitely a gamer. Gaming is one of his specialties, is something he loves to do, so I definitely think I'm gonna have him do that, but he might do social media. I don't know yet. I have so much that I want to do in this LP, so we'll have to just wait and see what happens. Is there anything else talk about him? I think that's pretty much it. I'll talk about his relationships after. Next we have is Gabriella Moore, which is his sister. She needs to go to the washroom. She is, as you can see, they're not even close. They just started out, so they're not even close. They're unknown. No one knows they exist, except themselves and their loved ones. So she is ambitious, she is self-absorbed, and she's romantic and alluring, but she is a serial romantic, actually. So that's okay. I was gonna talk about this love backstory, but we'll do that in 1 second. So that's pretty much them. And now we'll get into their backstory, and then I'll give you guys a house tour, and then we'll start playing the game because I'm super excited to get into this. I'll try not to make this backstory too long. So these two, growing up, they've had a very wild childhood. Right now, I don't have her family tree. Like I said, I had to work on this family late because I was hella lazy. I actually changed up the story about 5 different times. So that's why, their family tree is not ready yet, but I will finish that. Oops, okay, I thought I stopped the video, but I'll finish that before the next part. So, how it goes is that growing up, they never had the greatest childhood. They never really had a father figure in their life, sadly. But they did have a mother figure for at least 3 years after, well, when Gabriella, since she's the older one, and Gabriella was three, and when what's the name? Is Aiden, right? Yeah, Aiden. Okay, so I didn't change it. And when Aiden was two, sadly, their mom passed away. Passed away from a freak accident. Actually, she was coming home from work and she got hit by a car. It was a hit and run, and before they even got her to the hospital, she sadly passed away. So they had to deal with the loss of their mom at a very young age. They can't even remember their mom that much because they were just so young. And since then, they were living with their grandparents. So the grandparents was pretty much taking care of them ever since they were growing up. As actually they're growing up, you would think, I don't know if you can tell. I guess since I know the characters, I can tell. But growing up, Aiden was the problem child growing up, while Gabriella was the sweet one. So weird now because they're total opposites. But anyways, but yeah, growing up, Aiden was the one who got into trouble. I guess because he never had that stern father figure in his life, even though his grandpa tried to fill in, he never really had that connect. He rebelled. He would go out late at night. He would drink. He started drinking at the age of 13. He actually ended up almost joining a gang at one point. And by the way, with their backstory, they actually grew up in that place, back in that place that came with Jungle Adventure. That's where they grew up. That's where they were raised. And so they kind of immigrated over here. They just filed for their immigration license so they can be a permanent residence because this is where they want to start a life. This is where they want to be in. I don't remember what the city's called. I'm sorry. But this is where they want to live. But anyways, carrying on the story. So yeah, he got into a lot of trouble growing up. While since her brother was rebelling so much growing up, she Gabriella felt like she had to be, the good one, the one that, tried to kept her brother straight, tried to, keep herself in straight. She felt like she couldn't like react or couldn't do anything because Aiden was already giving their grandparents so much trouble and she didn't want to give them any trouble. So she was trying to be the perfect daughter, the perfect stepdaughter. I mean, not the perfect stepdaughter, the perfect granddaughter as she can be. She did her homework on time. She was an A student throughout high school. She did everything she needed to do. And she was the perfect student. But then another thing changed their life. Their grandfather passed away when Aiden was 13, and when but when Gabriella was 13, no, Gabriella was 14. And I think that's when I think that's when it blah 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 blah. I messed up. I messed up the story. I'm so sorry. Okay, you have to go back for a second. I'm not the best at telling stories. You guys can tell by now, right? I'm not the best. But keep all the information we had. I just messed up with the ages. That's it. So, our dude Aiden started drinking when he was 12. The grandfather passed away when Aiden was 14, and when Gabriella was 15. And then after that, Aiden decided that, you know what, he, well, for a few months after his grandfather's passing, he still rebelled, but then he started to see the weight that he put on his grandmother's shoulders, and then they started worrying for her health, and she became sick. And Aiden realized that he felt like he was the main cause of that because he was doing so much and causing her so much stress. So he calmed down and he started helping her around the house. He started getting his foot back on the right shoulder. That made no sense. Foot back on the right shoulder? What? He started getting back on the right path. That's what I'm trying to say. And he was doing better. And then him and Gabriella was trying their best to like pick up the slack for the grandmother. The grandmother stopped working, so money was tight around the house. It was pretty much the three of them. They had to find a way of struggling. It even came to the point where, even though they didn't want him to, they had to start stealing from stores just, to make ends meet, just to get by. But he didn't have much. The grandma couldn't afford it, anything. It was tough for them. And then when Gabriella was 17 and Aiden was 16, their grandmother sadly passed away, and that really hit them hard because they felt like they had no one except each other. They felt very alone, very, secluded. It was a hard time for them those few months. But before Graviella's and Aiden's grandmother passed away, she had a friend, and she asked her friend if they could take care of her grandkids, and of course she said yes, because that was like what her dying wish. You can't really say no to that, right? And so the friend, even though she didn't really want to, because again, her even herself, she was struggling too. She wasn't the richest person, so adding two more people to feed wasn't something she wanted to do. But of course, she was friends. Really good friends with their grandmother, so of course she said yes. So she took them in, and it was kind of like a like it was kind of like pity, a pity thing, because you could see that it was all out of pity. She never really treated them with, love or anything. She was just like, "You guys hungry? Here's your food." She didn't really ask them how they're doing in school. She just made sure that they went to school, It wasn't like she adopted them. She was just like a guardian for a sense. So it wasn't any love there. So for the first few months, it was hard for them to adjust. They felt like the outcasts. They didn't really eat around the table. It just felt awkward. But then, little by little, Argo Gabriella started crushing on the person who owns the house. So the grandmother's friend's son, and so they started crushing on each other, and they slowly started developing a relationship, which is great. It was like puppy love because it was her first crush. She was a very sheltered kid. Like I said, she never really rebelled. She was always this little quiet girl. She it was a big step for her to have a crush, for her to even engage with another guy, and for him to engage back. It was a very big step for her. And so they started a relationship, and then a few weeks later, a tourist group actually came in, and then our dude Aiden hooked up with one of the daughters of the tourist group, and after they actually ended up keeping communication, and so they started dating too. So they both actually ended up having, they both ended up being in a relationship with two different people, of course. We don't do incest here. And so that went on for a few years until they, of course, they graduated, and once they graduated, the person who owned the house, of course, let them stay with them because he couldn't really kick them out at 18. They had nowhere else to go. But then, I guess life started like really getting to them, and they had to start thinking about what they wanted to do in life. For Gabriella, she knew that she wanted to leave. I don't remember what that place is called back. It was what it called again? It came with Jungle Adventures. I don't know what it's called, but she knew she wanted to leave from there. She wanted to experience a new world. She's always been sheltered around there, and she's felt so, trapped. Like she felt like she couldn't be not herself, but who she really wanted to be. She felt like she had to put up this persona that everyone thought of her, and if she changed, people would flip out, and she just felt so trapped, And so she had this urge to leave, and with that urge, she started drifting away from I forget what his name is. her this dude, wait, not Clinton, okay. She started drifting away from Clinton little by little. And then Clinton, of course, Clinton is a very persistent dude. Like Clinton would not let her go no matter how much time she would like give him the hint that, you know what, maybe I want to move on, like this was puppy love, you are my first love, but that's good, like I need to experience the world, before I settle down. Because at that stage where they were living, for how long Clinton and her were dating, they were dating for about 5 years. They started dating when she was around 17, and they were around 22 at this time, so about 5 years. And so at that time, people thought, they were gonna get married because people married young at that age, and they were gonna have kids. He was gonna on a farm, and they just he pretty much had their life planned out, and that scared the hell out of her because she wanted to do some other stuff. She wanted to experience, the limelight. She always watched TV shows of movie stars and actors, and she's always been curious about that, and she just always wanted to do that. But again, that was just a secret passion. Who would have thought, the little girl from the village wanted to be, a superstar, an actor? It just wasn't something you say out loud. So that was kind of her little secret. So once Clinton started talking about, marriage and settling down and having kids at age of 22, she got scared and she freaked out. And she's told him straight up that she's leaving, and that she couldn't do this, and that, they needed a break, and just she just needed, she wanted to run. And so that same day she called, same day she called work, told them, she's done, she's quit, she got everything out of her savings, and she told her brother, "Listen, I'm moving. Do you want to come with me or not?" And at that moment, of course, in Clinton, not Clinton's life, in Aiden's life, he was dating Dominique, which was the tourist girl. And they were actually, they have the most roller coaster-ish relationship ever. Like, since it's long distance, they both cheated on each other so many times and broken up and then flown to each other's houses and gone back together. It's just been a real emotional roller coaster. And so when Clint, not when Clinton, so when our dude Aiden found out, you know, that his sister was moving, and since Brindleton Bay is only a town over from where they live right now, he was super excited. Of course, he was down to go, and so he called up his girl Dominique and said, "Yo," so I'm not yo, but he told her that he was moving, and of course, Dominique wanted to come live with them because they were dating for a good long too. So they've been dating for about 4 years now, and so, you know, she wanted to move in with them too because she wanted to move in. She wanted to leave her parents' house and move in with them. But our girl, what's her name again? Jesus, our girl Gabriella did not want anything to do with Dominique. Like, Gabriella doesn't like Dominique in the sense that she knows how much Dominique hurt her brother, and she doesn't want to hate her for it, but she dislikes her for it, you know? And so when Gabriella heard that, you know, Dominique wants to come live with them, she was a hard no. She was like, "That ain't happening on that my dead body. She's staying where she's staying, and that's what I said is what I said is what I said. You ain't going anywhere." And then Dominique, being the feisty woman she is, she got pissed off at Gabriella, and so they had this huge fight over the phone, and then Gabriella started like yelling back, and then you know she started yelling at her brother, and then it was just a whole big mess to the point where she hates, like, where Gabriella hates Dominique and Dominique hates Gabriella. And so she kind of called it quits with that relationship. She's like, "You know what, you do guys want to do, she's just not moving in." And so that's where they are right now. They packed up everything they got. She pretty much ended off her relationship with Clinton, kind of. They haven't really called it quits. He's still trying to, you know, pursue her, but she's like, "I'm good." But he's so persistent. He's so persistent. She doesn't know how to let him down. Aiden right now is still dating Dominique, even though they kind of had a huge fight over her not being able to move in because she was gonna come a brat about it. They're still strong. They're still going. I have no clue how long the relationship's going to last, but that's where they're at right now. And so they pretty much packed up their bags, found the cheapest house in this neighborhood. This house, I think, was on like this house was like on extremely big sale, so they picked it up as they go. As you can see, we have $282 left. And so this is the house that they're moving in. So I just want to say thank you guys so much for listening to that. I know my stories are all over the place. I should probably write this down, but I don't know. I have the storyline pretty much lined out. I just have to put in the little details, and that's how I speak to you guys with the details. And that sometimes I mix up my details, and it's all over the place. But I think I did a pretty good job. So hopefully that was clear. It wasn't really too in depth. I didn't really go into like their personalities too much. Just that right now, Gabriella is feeling hella free. She's feeling free to do whatever she wants. She feels like she can break out of her shell and do whatever she like. Honestly, she feels like a new person. She can finally start anew, and no one can judge her for it. While Clinton, not Clinton, Jesus, keep on mixing Clinton and Aiden. While Aiden is just trying to figure out his relationship with Dominique. So that's where they're at right now with themselves. But this is the house. Should I do a house tour with like first person? Wouldn't that be something? But let me guys show you guys a really quick tour of this house. Let me just speed this through, okay? So this is the front door, of course, and then once you walk through the front door, you get to the foyer, and then you have the kitchen. I did not make this house, by the way. I got off the gallery. And then you have the living room with the little Xbox because Aiden is a gamer. So we had the Xbox for him. Like I said, it's really bare bones. They're starting from the bottom, so I can't really wait. I can't wait to see where they're gonna get, you know. And so this is Clinton's room. He's got the computer, and he's also got a laundry basket, and he's got a bed. I definitely need to place a laundry mat down because that's what they're gonna be doing the laundry. And then there's some stairs right here to go up the stairs. How do we do it again? Is it E? Oh yeah, it's E. W E W E W. Oh, look at that. We'll climb up the stairs. Ooh, y'all see that? We climb up the stairs. So now this part, the lofted area, is Gabriella's room. So this is for Gabriella's days. She's got a mirror. This is like the only piece of custom content I actually have in the house. I'm trying to keep it fair, so I'm not trying to cheat and get a bunch of cheap beds and all that. When they have enough money, they can like splurge on it, of course, and it makes sense. Then of course I'll do some custom content, but for right now, I'm keeping it bare necessities with Max's match. So here is Gabriella's room. It's just a bed and a laundry basket, and then she has her own bathroom, and there also is a bathroom downstairs that I miss, and then there's a little balcony over here, and that gives you a view to down there, and this is the neighborhood of, I don't remember what the town's called, but yeah, that's pretty much it for this chat session. 20 minutes of me talking. I'm sorry. That must have been torture for you guys. If you're still listening to this by now, you're an OG. But anyways, let's just get straight into this part. I'm super excited to play this game. I've started a new blah blah blah. I haven't started a new LP on this channel in a hot minute. Let me just move that right there. Okay, so first thing to do today is job-wise, what do I want them to do? I know for a fact that I think I'm gonna have Gabriella work as an actor, and she's also gonna be, I think it's like, I have no clue if you can be an actor and also work with the social media stuff. I don't have any clue on what came with this pack. I just got it. I felt like if I read about it, I would have ruined it for myself, but now I'm like, I'm very uninformed, so I don't know what I could do with the pack. All I know is that there's an acting career. That's pretty much it. And I'm pretty sure there's also like a vlogging career or a YouTube type of thing. So I wanted her to do the YouTube thing plus the acting, but if it's only the YouTube thing. And I also wanted him to be a DJ. I thought that'd be something fun for him to do, because he does like music, but we can't really afford a DJ booth. So rip to me. So what I do want you to do real quick is, let's go ahead and find you a job. So registered for, I don't know, what the heck is that? You know what that means? I'm so confused. Register for the minister of what? What is that gonna do? Mm-hmm. Register your career. What's your title? Job description. Oh, you can make your own jobs? Did that come with the thing, or is that a mod in my game? I don't know. That is so weird. I didn't even notice that. Okay, find a job. That's cool though. You can register and you can make your own careers. That's actually insanely cool. But anyways, so we're gonna go ahead and find a job. And she is, was there anything else we have here? We have, a style influencer. There's always that. I haven't done that. That's, I think that came with the update. We could do like, maybe she could be the style influencer and he could be the actor, but I want her to be the actress. That's something she always wanted to do. Okay, I'll do that. She will be the actress. And I think, okay, let's see. AI staffing agency. Consider AI staffing agency. Blank your name. So that'd be Gabriella. Are agents look forward to booking or rejected time to benefits? That isn't bad. What's this one? Everyday Extras Talent Agency. Our team has put roles and benefits. More auditions. Okay, I like this one more because this is more auditions for commercials and daytime TV, which is definitely something she would want to do. Sorry guys, I just how I read. I read in my head. I apologize and I read out loud, but it's right there if you guys want to read it. You can just pause and read it yourself. But I think we're gonna do this one. I like that. So there we go. Knife. So she has joined Everyday Extras Agency. Welcome to the crew, Gabriella. We are we specialize in getting talent service staff members into acting roles, big and large. Some of our talents even land gigs with actual lines to speak. Oh, that sounds exciting. Don't let the pressure get to you. What? Don't let the pressure get you though. We can also arrange a few shifts at what's that? Shezalama? What the heck is that? When need. Okay. True. I guess we can work there if we need money. That's cool. Thanks for the heads up. Agency. So there we go. So she has.
Then haze.
So she makes $640 a gig. Moochie, peachy, I'm so glad this works. I'm so new to this. Well, of course, the pack just came out. But anyways, let's see. Check for gigs. Sure, let's do that. And then my dude, let's see. Social media, career, right. Let's see. Create a social media timeline. Sure. You can create one, and then we'll have your sister create one too when we're done. I also need to. Okay, what's this? We need charisma level 2, and we need guitar level 2. God dang it. Okay, so that means. I hate when my son says that. I feel like something's glitching out. Okay, so charisma level 2, that means we need to make some people, which means we need some friends. Are you a celebrity? I think so, because you. Global superstar. Okay, hold up. Let's meet our first celebrity. Ask for a hug, ask for an autograph, ask for a selfie. No, thank you. Attempt an introduction. Friendly. Attempt an introduction, ask for a hug. Sure, let's attempt an introduction. This is gonna go down extremely bad, but hey, our first celebrity. Why not? Looking like a little ghetto ass Marilyn Monroe. I'm joking. But okay, let's see how this turns out. I'm curious. I feel we're gonna get turned down hardcore. She'd be like, I'm too good for you. I've been the extra of Marilyn Monroe for years. You can't touch me. Anyways, here we go. Jesus Christ! Hold up. I need to see her reaction to this. What is this? You need to calm yourself. I've never seen someone so excited. Oh, she's dazzling and everything. Hold up, I need some screenshots. Look at her. She's like, oh my god. Oh, you geeking out so hard. Of course that didn't go well. Does people actually think screaming in people's faces like, oh my god, it's gonna get you like a hay back? No, it's gonna get you like sent to like a sane asylum. What did you expect? Okay, here we go. Gabriella, we've come to you with some season 4 talent agency. In fact, we've pulled in directly out of our wall. Handbook. Before any actors can take the stage, provide proof they are celebrating this first audition. Check for new daily things. Paying attention to the recommendation skills, post da da da. After success of audition, the gig will be scheduled for filming. Follow the date. This is good advice. We will make sure to follow this on that all to all actors. Okay. Not right now. Okay, sure. Well, I can't do it right now because we don't have any of this. We're trying to work on a charisma skill, but it's not going too well. Did it work? What's this? Oh, that didn't go over so... Okay, sassy pants. She thinks she's hot shit, don't you? You end up in a garbage can if you don't stop. Anyways, honestly, she thinks she's like the ish. But anyways, oh, there's a park here. That's awesome. Okay, hold up. I see people. I can't speak English. So who do we have? We can make friends. No, not you. Mortimer Goth, that would be something. Oh, there's you. Here we go, Salem. Let's go talk to you. Will we give you a free introduction? You know what? Why not? She's recently, well, she's not single, but you know what? In her mind, she's single, so that's what it counts. And so she's, oh, and they have like balloons. So does that mean you need seasons for all of this? Because this comes with seasons, unless this comes with this expansion pack too. So I'm pretty sure this, like, I don't know. Maybe it doesn't. Let me know down below if this comes with seasons or not, because I'm pretty sure that does. So I'm guessing you need seasons for that. Who even knows? Anyways. He's feeling it. Okay. What's good?
So.
Discuss interests. Hearts and everything. Bro's feeling herself. Ask about love life. I really come here to get his number, but hey, why not? Ask about his day. And then we're going to more. Actually, okay, hold up. Pause. While we're doing this, why don't you go ahead and... You know what he can do now? So let's go ahead, do that. And what's this? plus frame upload, this will give you a frame point of that a fame point. That's cool. On the road to fame, Sims now have the ability to become celebrities. Yay! There are many different ways to become celebrities, and as your Sims progress in their skills and careers, more paths to stardom will become available. Some great ways to become famous includes pursuing a career in acting or rising the media production skill via the video. Where's that located? I guess that's new. Okay, so look for that. But okay. Enough said. Y'all read that? I read that. Okay. So we've gained, let's see, you've gained 20 followers. We have 20 followers now. Awesome. Okay, so social network. Where's social media? Check timeline. I've no clue if that's it or not. Oh, she's pissed. I still don't understand the stupid thing. Like, I can't even get rid of it. It sucks. And now she's MC. Oh, I miss my IU. I wish I missed my mod so much. You could just, like, click this and get rid of this. It's not needed, though. Is there, like, a way to get rid of these mods? Because there's no reason for her to be angry. It was because of that stupid glitch that happened in my game and the birthday, whatever. But, MC Dresser, not Dresser, MC Cheats. I'm changing to a good mood. Makes him happy. There we go. Wait, is that cheat her needs too? Oops. I just want to make her happy. Is that free food I see? It is. Oh, this is working out well. That's free food. Okay, dude. Nice. But anyways, heartfelt compliment. Let's get this charisma skill up so we can Gorba. Do this gig.
Oh, Vadish.
And then who's the other? Oh, there's Nico. But I know she's cooking up too, so let's not bother her. Because that is more free food on our way. Ooh, and there's some rocks and stuff. Mortimer's chilling. We have a bunch of. I actually love this alleyway. That's pretty cool. Let's see. Is there anybody else in this street that we can, you know, say hello to? Say what's good? Okay, I guess not. But there's a lemon tree over there, which is cool. But anyways, when you're done this, why don't you go ahead and multiplayer video game, play online, play game, play some video games, I guess. Social media. Is there anything else we can do? Okay, let's do this again. Sell to Sher. We're gonna hold up. No, let's send. Is there a bad picture we can sell? Because I think that's a good one. Yeah, that's a good one. Is there like a bad one we can sell by any chance? Here we go. Oh, here we go. Sell. When you're done, sell that. And maybe we can make some money. Who even. Wait, can we actually make money on it? Maybe we can't because we're selling it. Who knows? Maybe we'll sell it for $1. But we're getting a fame point, so that's good. And then his fame thing is he's still at zero. Which sucks, but it's whatever. Anyways, so we're gonna continue talking to this dude. Discuss interests. We just need you to help us. Get our charisma skill up. Gossip? No. Deep conversation? No. Come on. Get to know? No. Discuss interests? No. No. Where's all the charisma stuff at? Ask about a day, I guess. Get to know. Come on, where's the charisma stuff at?
Pak Yoin
Lumla. She's in a good mood.
Kibaya. So
come on now.
Conversation.
I don't actually want to get to know the guy. I just want to get a charisma skill up. You know what? He's gonna use this to me right now.
Karenzi. Oh,
Bouchard. I think I see something. No, I don't. Get to know.
Finkuyus Lekem.
Hug a share photo now. Okay, whatever. Not worth my time. Miko, we're talking to you now. Bye. He's not helping us at all in our situation. We need minutes.
Dag.
What's up? Okay. So, there we go. Brian up there. Miko, perfect.
Oh, kiss and then nice Brian up there again. Flish? Hando.
Compliment. Brian up there. Perfect. Compliment. Brian up. There we go. Okay. Get some more of these in. And then we can go ahead and, check for gigs and ready for our first gig audition, and we'll see how bad that turns out, because I'm not expecting the best because it's our first. Like, what's the chances of us actually getting our first ever audition? If we do, though, we lit. But if we don't, then it's expected, right? So anyways, he's gonna go ahead and play these video games real quick. And again, I have no clue how this social media thing even works. Okay, here we go. Salt, Suds commercial. Let's do it. So how does it work now? Do we like... how do we do this now? Discuss. Cancel audition. What's the audition? Okay, so the audition is tomorrow. Excuse me. Audition is tomorrow at 7 p.m. Monday. Okay, we got this. It is almost 4 something, but you know what that means? We're going partying tonight. Of course she is. Her stay home. I think her brother might stay home because he's not really the party type anymore. He might come out, who knows. But she's definitely going out. It's her first night on the town. She needs to make some friends. Nico's chill and everything, but... I'm not saying Nico's bad or anything, but you know, more friends is the better, right? Compliment her outfit. Let's keep on trying to choose meat.
Gorba.
Brian up day.
Doba Harfin.
Yafa.
Brian up day.
Flish. Hando.
Jonga. Interactions up. But I think we're done. We'll be the best friends with her. Oh, Akira, yo, it's the neighborhood hoe. I'm telling you though, when City Living came out, every single person had a kid with him.
Oh.
Everyone. It was amazing. The amount of Let's Plays I've watched where they've got with this dude. I'm like, but anyways, poor Miko had the biggest crush on the dude, but ended up sleeping with everybody else. Like, Kili's still your mom, so watch out for him. But anyway.
Zafis, Moochie Peachy, Senju.
Brighten up day.
Dombila Nebris.
Oh. Discuss interest. we can try to cheer him up.
Flish.
Brighten up day.
Uh-huh.
Where's compliment outfit?
Exanoi Zots. Was Susa.
Where's compliment outfit? Ask about day.
Hello? I'm on your frisk.
Did it work? Oh, it looked like it worked. You're welcome, Akira. That's what friends are for. Do an impression.
Gorba.
We got an angel point. What does that do? What is angel? Level 3 in the charisma scale. Oh, I see this. Neutral. Okay, to keep on I can't pronounce that word. Reputation. Good, okay. Heartfelt compliment. More friendly.
Flish.
I'm telling you, she's gonna ruin it. No matter how good it gets, she's gonna find a way to ruin it, because that's what she does. She's feeling it right now. She's feeling so mischievous. She's feeling so flirty.
Go Larga, Sense and Varicky.
One way or another. What's this?
New zip towel.
Okay, so it's almost time for us to go out. I do want to hit up the town real quick, so let's see what they have. I know this town is hella disappointing. Like, hella disappointing. But thank you, Akira, for keeping us occupied for a little bit. This is hella, like, come on, you could have, like, you know, added something over here, you know? Like, why? Just, like, 1, 2, 3. Like, if they honestly, like, made this to, like, a neighborhood and put this over here, I would have been so happy. But, like, really? And it's only really? EA. And you had all this beach over here that you, really? Anyways. You can tell I'm not the happiest about the situation. But there's a park, there's a gym, we're going to the gym. That seems pretty litter than the park. We're gonna go and hopefully meet some people. Meet some friends. Like, again, she is in her mind, she is single. She has tried to break up with that dude, but he just won't take no for an answer, so she just gave up. But we'll have to see. So anyways, we're gonna go over here and hit up the gym real quick. Ooh, there's a swimming pool. Here we go swimming. So there's a swimming pool. There's the front desk. What's upstairs? This gym actually doesn't look that bad. It reminds me of my actual, like, I have a thing called Cathy Campbell near my house. This looks exactly like it. There's a pool and there's like a view from upstairs from the pool. But anyways, let's go over here and hit a workout real quick. Maybe we'll find some celebrities in this neighborhood that we can kind of, you know, talk to again, because we kind of messed up the first time pretty bad. So here is one. No, not one, but who's this? Dustin. Oh, he's a B-lister. Oh, okay, Dustin, what's good? Attempt introduction. He's just a B-lister, so it ain't that bad. We should get somewhere with him. Hopefully. He has headphones on. I wonder if he's actually listening to music, or does he think that's actually cool? I have no clue. But we're gonna. Oh, who's this? Is that paparazzi I see? Man, okay, let's get. Okay, hold up. What's this? Are you gonna come, fanboy, over here, Cassandra God? Oh, she is fanboy. A fan. What else we have? Paparazzi. Girl, what did I tell you? That's not how you. Really. Real face down, ass up. That's the way I like to. Anyways, but all his girl fainted. His hunter got fainted in that position. That is not safe. Ooh, that is not safe, child. You would be in, like, okay, anyways, we're not gonna think about that. Some predators are on the watch. But, anyways, I honestly, I've been telling her this. This is not how you meet a celebrity, child. Like, you don't do it like this. Like, you don't do it like this. Like, have some respect for yourself. Just say, hi, what's good? How are you? Don't be like, yo, I love you. Like, you the ish. Like, no. You don't do that, son. But anyways, I'm actually gonna go ahead and end off this part here. I hope you guys enjoy. Thank you guys so much for watching, and of course I'll talk to you guys on the flip side as always. I'm out, guys. Deuces. Peace. Bye. Laters. Thank you guys again for watching. Oops. Okay, there we go. Okay, guys, bye, guys.